I'll keep this close.
Chest is like unwrapping a gift.
Reward on the road.
The wide range of ingredients you can find in Mondstadt, and it looks like it's true! No, I'm a chef! A chef on a mission to find rare and exotic ingredients from all corners of the world! My name's Xiang Ling. I'm from Liyue Harbor. And you?
Hello, my name's Paimon!
Paimon!
Why are you looking at me like that?
What an exotic creature! Is it edible?
What?
What a bummer. Can't eat it if it's your friend. You seem like good friends. I have a good friend too, called Guoba.
Isn't that the name of a Liyue snack?
Both the snack and my friend have a special place in my heart. Anyway, can you do some hunting for me? There's lots of game around here that would be amazing to cook with. I can't catch anything to save my life, and I don't want to miss out. Sounds like a bit of an
Don't be like that.
Come on, I'll whip you up a tasty snack later.
Ooh, you had me a tasty snack. Don't worry, we're the bestest hunters ever.
Don't worry about it. Your friend has already given me a response. I don't care how it's done, so long as you bring me back some raw meat. Great! Then I'll leave you to it.
Ha!
Deep fry with mushrooms. Ooh, and I wonder how well it goes with slime condensate.
Yay! You have finally come around to my food preferences.
Sorry. I got all excited thinking about new recipes.
As promised, a tasty snack. Go on, try it. And are we your food testers now? Oh gosh, this is delicious. Can you tell us how to make it?
Sure. The only thing is I got it. I'll make another one now so you can watch. I'm sure you'll pick it up straight away.
This seems pretty hard to make. It'll take more than that to learn how to make it. And we don't have a frying pan or any condiments.
Come on, it's simple. We can fry on a slab of stone and cook using some boar fat. Build a stove from rocks. Use dry grass for kindling, twigs for firewood. Sweet flowers will do for sugar. As for salt, I found a load of rock salt in a cave the other day. I just can't help myself when there's a chance to try something new. But I can't exactly bring my whole kitchen with me every time I leave the house, either.
True.
Give me a second while I get everything ready.
Okay.
Hey! What do you think?
Who are you?
This is the boar's natural habitat. You can't... We hunters know better than to kill the chicken to get at the egg.
Oh, I get it. The freshest, best quality meat comes from free-range boars that grow up in the environment nature intended for them. If they all ran off, it would be a major blow to gastronomy. No, to all mankind. I'm sorry. I got excited and didn't think of the impact we'd have.
It's okay.
You should apologize to Draff. As our leader, he always stresses the importance of respecting the rules of the hunt. I'm afraid he is very upset right now.
I made a mistake, and I should go and apologize.
Thanks, guys. Okay, don't worry. Draff ought to be in Springvale. Let's go!
I'll race you there!
Yeah, no worries. I'm not picking.
You must be Xiangling.
Sorry, Mr. Draff. This was all my fault.
I heard the whole story, and now that you're here in person...
Ooh, he's gonna let her have it.
Please, help me promote my meat!
Huh?
Sorry if I was a little brash. Let me explain. Springvale has built its reputation on top quality meat products, but this reputation is so far limited to Mondstadt. When I heard that the great maestro Xiangling herself was in Mondstadt, I asked Alan to send you over.
Maestro?
Haven't you heard? She's the one behind Wan Min Restaurant, that one-of-a-kind folk restaurant in Liyue Harbor. Her unique take on cooking ingredients is behind some of the best-loved dishes in all of Liyue. They are very highly rated by travelers, too.
Okay. You're too kind. I just try to cook things that are cheap and cheerful.
With a top-notch chef cooking top-notch cuisine with top-notch meat from Springvale, our reputation would spread far and wide.
I don't know. I only ever think about how to make tasty dishes. I never limit myself to specific ingredients, and I don't know the first thing about promoting anything.
You use boar meat all the time anyway, surely. I can't see what the issue is.
The issue is... What would you think if I added a bit of slime condensate?
That's... I mean, Couldn't you add something a bit more normal?
There's no such thing as normal ingredients to me. You can turn anything into a delicacy if you cook it in the right way.
Very true.
I will not stand for having my creativity shackled by what ingredients I can and can't use. So...
Well, since you feel so...
You know, we did come to apologize. Couldn't you be a little more flexible?
It's one thing to apologize, but it's another thing entirely to change the way I approach cooking.
What's that smell? It's gorgeous! Delicious cooking?
Sorry, I've taken all the orders I can for the next few days. The earliest I could put you down for-
Wow, it must be delicious if it's that popular. Yeah, good point. Why does Draft want Xiangling to help when Springville already has this lady?
Maybe he feels that Mondstadt cuisine can't compete with that of Teyvat's biggest business hub, Luya Harbor. But I disagree. I don't think my cooking is at all inferior to anyone else's.
To me, cooking seems pretty average, pretty similar to everyone else's cooking.
Well then, show me what you got!
Sorry, but customer feedback like, oh, that tasted good, is no use to me. If I wanted feedback, I would ask a professional chef.
That's me!
It's really you! Well, I guess you do know what you're doing when it comes to cooking meat then. As it happens, I have one of today's prime cuts remaining. So tell me, how would you cook this?
Why was the complete...
But that depends on the ratio of fat to meat. With this cut, I would probably roast it over a hot stone with a little salt, some Joyun chili, and Kingsen flour.
Kingsen flour? But the melted fat would make the flavor of the flowers 10 times stronger than when eaten raw. It would overpower everything.
I know, that's why it's a garnish. I would never marinate the meat in it. I've tried it before. If you baste the petals in oil and then cook them with the right heat and duration, it gets rid of the bitterness completely and leaves you with a lovely crispy topping.
Okay.
Then throw in some Joyun chilies grown at a high altitude where the low humidity and varying temperatures lends them a unique dry heat. The petals absorb the saltiness from the sea salt, the chili spice, and the umami of the tender freshly grilled steak, while also adding a floral aftertaste.
That's pure overkill! You're going all out on the trimmings and doing no justice to the meat whatsoever! Who wants to eat a roast when you can taste everything except the roast?
Whoa! Stop arguing!
Well, there's only one surefire way out of a cooking dispute. I declare a cook-off!
Suits me. If you can't beat my cooking, it'll show that
All right. But if I...
And if you lose, you have to add my winning dish to the Wanmin menu. With a caption saying, "This special addition to the Wanmin menu is generously provided by Chef Brooke of Springvale, meat expert."
It's a deal! I'm off to get ingredients. I will see you all... Wait! Let's try and catch up.
What? Okay, so I'm gonna leave this one to later because I just want to complete the current one I'm doing. Which is... Where is it? This one. Crystal Tears. This is the one I originally wanted. You know, I want to go all the way there and for nothing. So I'm gonna leave that one to the next episode. There's no one running all the way there to get a bit some stupid cooking.
Huh!
Action Squad, assemble!
Let's put our crystals together. Oh, the color of these crystals looks muddy. Dvalin, you're going through so much pain. Let's start purifying these crystals first. Please.
It is hard to believe such a thing is possible until you've seen it with your own eyes.
Interesting. It's like filtering wine. The process is refreshing.
I think we should have enough tears now. So next we use the crystals on the Holy Lyre like last time.
It seems completely different from before.
The Lyre's animal power seems fully restored. We should be able to use it now.
Oh, hell yeah.
It's all thanks to you.
Now, where should we summon Stormterror? It must be away from the city, else there will be casualties should we fail. Perhaps here at the winery?
If the winery was destroyed, it's not something I couldn't eventually fix. But I'd still rather not go through the hassle.
The wind that blows at sea or in high places should be able to carry a bard's words far away. It's never going to work if the air is too dry or suffocating.
Paimon understands. Sea or high places, right? Then the best location to play the lyre would be...
Even Amber would never think of doing such a thing.
If you go east from Starfell Lake, there are mountains south of the beach.
Oh, you mean that beach we were on when you told Paimon about your sister?
If you head to where the cliff juts out, that place is known as Star Snatch Cliff. What do you think, Bard? Meets the requirements, no?
Let me think. Star Snatch Cliff. All right, let's do it there.
Very well. Then let's meet at Star Snatch Cliff when we're ready. Please don't be late.
Yes, ma'am!
Sorry.
Well, that's...
May the wind guide us in saving Dvalin.
Everyone is finally here.
What a view!
Lovely for a fated reunion, isn't it? Well, we must be prepared for a fight.
Regardless of the outcome, things finally seem to be taking a turn for the better. Mondstadt has really been going through so much recently.
Huh. In the end, the solution to our problem was as simple as a traveler in a song. I suppose the Knights of Favonius may have played a part in it too.
Oh, we get it, Master D-Luke. Everyone! Please step aside. I, the best wandering bard of the mortal world, shall begin my...
Yeah. done cannot be undone.
Then why do I see sadness in your eyes? Sadness that speaks of your yearning for this song.
We are communicating. Venti, please, be careful.
You've known my troop, though. I thank you.
How's the holy lyre? Can it still be played, or does it need to be repaired?
Unfortunately, I think it's beyond repair.
No. We should make that abyss mage pay first. If we don't fight the evil at its source, then we can't save D'Valin at all.
In which case, I shall call upon Outrider Amber to track it down.
No need.
Why is that?
I eradicated one not long ago, in one of the Four Winds temples.
What?
If you want to track those monsters down, then I'll seek answers from my contacts. I've got other means for getting the job done.
Though he dislikes the Knights of Siphonius, he protects Mondstadt in his own way.
Oh? Why does our little Paimon sound so doting all of a sudden?
Wait for my word. I'll be sure to let the Abyss Order know that their blatant disregard for Mondstadt will not go unpunished.
When your home returns to this world, we shall revel in its glory.